trying to go natural.
Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm giving you guys a bonus Black Friday video. I've seen a lot of my subbies have been asking for it. What's like the second most requested recently besides they want to see my stash? And I will show you my stash one day, I really will. Maybe even soon. Anyway, but before I get a riot in the comments, let's focus my Black Friday wish list. This is me telling you guys what I really want to get, which is different from my recommendations because this is stuff that I want to get most likely because I haven't tried yet. You know how PJs do, we want to try the new and the stuff we missed because we know what the good stuff is like already and we just like that rush of new product. I know it's a little horrible, but you know what I mean? We really enjoy trying new stuff. So I will have a few restocks, but my stash is huge. I don't really need to buy a lot of stuff, especially stuff I already have. And I would like to just, for the fun of it, kind of focus on stuff I haven't tried. Unless I'm really out of something I like. But if I still have like a bottle or jar or something I like, I'm not gonna restock yet. That's back in the day. That's 2016 or something, before my stash got this big. Back in the day, I used to buy like 2, 3 and all of the same type of leave-in. We don't do that no more because we have too much stuff. Way too much stuff for that. So I usually just tend to buy one of everything. I think even last year I was buying like 2 of things just in case I like it. Even if I like it, I'll be liking other things in my stash. So one big thing about this year is pretty much you're gonna just see one of everything. I think top of my list is Sultanicals, just because I haven't bought Sultanicals in a long time. I really want to support. I just bought way too much stuff at first. I was buying on every single cereal, so you can imagine how much Sultanicals I stocked up. But I think I'm finally where I'm on my last Frizz Whiz. So I definitely want to buy a new Frizz Whiz leave-in. You know, that's my HD leave-in, my second HD leave-in with NRC. Hoping to get a salon size, but I'm not really sure how she's going to do Black Friday. So I'd be really sad if I don't get a salon size, but I probably won't get one. I have to pay attention now to see if there are any other salon size sales. I know she was selling salon size recently, but it didn't look like a sale. I'm hoping for the Hibiscus DC to come back. Ayo, if you're watching, I'm gonna tag you on the video so that you can make my dream happen and that Hibiscus DC to come back. Because I looked today and I didn't see it on the list of items. So, Hibiscus DC, my want. And that Fenugreek DC looks interesting, so I wanna try that from Sultanicals. So that's 3 things from Sultanicals that I wanna try. And I'm hoping that I can get my hands on all of them. Next on the list, Curl Origin Pink Superfoods. Everything looks really good. And I've heard great things about them. So you know Curl Origin, I've been loving it more than it's been loving me this year. But I really love my first try of it and I haven't given up. 50% off probably. I am going to try the Pink Superfoods and I really hope that it loves me the way I want it to love me. So the cleanser looked really interesting, the deep conditioner, everything looked good. So I'm curious to try. A Gorgeously Kinky. They pretty much redid everything from when I last tried them, so I pretty much want to buy everything again. I may not buy the styling milk just because the last time I tried it, it wasn't my favorite, but I'm going to definitely buy the Intense Quench DC, definitely buy the new Nut Melt leave-in that they have, and definitely buy the Curls Galore Jelly. So I think I still haven't tried the Honey Wheat from last Black Friday. But after I try that with the other gel, I'm gonna try the new stuff with the new gel. Yeah, look forward to some Gorgeously Kinky next year because I'm definitely excited to be getting that for Black Friday. So yeah, another 3 items there. Pink Superfoods, I'm not sure exactly how much is in the line, but I'm thinking like it's gonna be another 3 or 4 items. We're gonna have stuff. Hopefully not too much stuff, but we're gonna have a little bit of stuff. The Nasty Naturals, I really wanna get more of their shampoo. You know I love their shampoo. If I get the chance, I'm buying the whole gallon size moisturizing shampoo, like the biggest one they have, because I love it that much. I could just probably use it all of next year happily, but I still have a lot of other shampoos to get, I don't want to say get rid of, but to get through. Once I finish getting through all of that, it's going to just be me, Blue Rose Beauty, Nasty Naturals, and Baskin Bloom, basically for cleansers. With, you know, I'm trying new ones. I want to try the Pink Superfoods cleanser, so I'm still going to be trying new ones. But I think I'm trying a lot less new shampoos this year and a lot less new gels this year too. So yeah, in fact, I'm hardly trying anything this year. Okay, y'all believe me. Okay, I'm thinking about trying their clarifying shampoo. Like part of me is curious and part of me is like, leave well enough alone. Why you want it? I know people say you should clarify. I don't really clarify. I don't use heavy products in the whole, but I tend to use moisturizing shampoos. I don't really use clarifying shampoos. Every now and again I would use Kinky Curly, but even then I mix it with something. So I might get their clarifying shampoo, just because their moisturizing shampoo has been so good to me. If their clarifying shampoo is also kind of good to me, you know, I'll be very happy. Moisturizing shampoo for sure. Leave-in depending on shipping, clarifying shampoo depending on how curious I get, and the conditioner, since I haven't tried the one before, I have no business trying it, so that depends on how carried away I get, basically. Pills and potions, I still want to try the Chibe stuff. I've wanted to try it for the last several years, but every time I try it, it's like something sold out and I'm not able to get it. So I'm hoping again this year. I think I'm on the mailing list. I'm going to double check. I'm going to try to figure out when the sales start to see if I can get it. If you guys have tried the Curls and Potions Chibe stuff, definitely let me know, because I do want to try, but every time I try, it's like sold out. So I have Hope Alive again this year. It's on my wish list for this year. So Natural Club, like I said, I already kind of cheated and bought it. So it's kind of wish list in the sense that I'm wishing for it right now because I haven't used it yet, but I have bought it. I just bought it recently. If you follow my kind of YouTube stories or something, or you follow me on Instagram, you would have seen my photo. And I'm looking forward to trying out those products for sure, especially the gel. We'll see what we get. And I guess if I try it and love it, I probably will go back for it for Black Friday. So hey, wish list. Anyhow, Natural Club, definitely on my I'm curious about, can't wait to try. Sale is good and I wanna buy some, or try some. Try some, then buy some. We'll see what happens. So Baskin Bloom, I really like, I'm fully stocked on their cleanser in DC, otherwise that would be on the list for sure. But I do love their gel, so I do want to buy that. I do so want to try their mousse. I've heard great, fabulous things about their mousse. Again, like if the shipping is right, if I can get the shipping to work out, then I'll be buying it. So overall, I want to spend $10 or less a product, basically, including shipping. After I do the math, it's like, okay, this is like under 15 for sure, under 12 we good, under 10, yes we talking, I might buy it. So that's the kind of math I'll be going on to determine if I get the Baskin Bloom. But in terms of wishing, I definitely really want to try the mousse and really want to get back to the jelly. Curls Dynasty is also on the list. I did see it in Target, I even picked it up, but then I was like, why am I buying this full price in Target? I'm gonna wait a little bit and see what kind of sale they have on Black Friday. So they didn't tell us what their sale was on Instagram, they just said that their sale was super awesome, I don't know. So I signed up for the mailing list, and if the sale is good, I'm gonna be getting some Curls Dynasty. I wanna try their custard, although it looks more like a cream. And I wanna try their like shampoo or cleanser or something like that. And of course, just like a deep conditioner and leave-in to just make a nice wash day for you guys. I've never tried their brand. So Curls Dynasty, Natural Club, I haven't tried those brands at all. And then the rest of them, I may not have tried the particular items I'm getting. The Alolia Hair Care Cream Gel is definitely on my list. I've been trying to get that for a while now. You'll see if it's available and, you know, everything aligns, I'm going to be getting that Alolia Hair Care Cream Gel. I don't think I will be buying the rest of the stuff. Like, everything was good, but like I have so much stuff, I have to be really selective. So I just want to maybe try the cream gel and maybe pair it with something else, I don't know. We'll see what I do. I'm gonna kind of go over all the products again and decide, but the cream gel is definitely on my wish list from Alolia Hair Care. Honey's Handmade, I have no business buying it. I have no business buying any of this, y'all, but I really have no business buying Honey's Handmade because I still have some, but it's gonna be 65% off, 60% off. I'm gonna lose my mind and probably get one or two things, like just deep conditioners or something, just to put my toe in, basically. So, and like I said, it's gonna moisturize my hair, 65% off. It's just, we winning, you know? Even though we lose it because we have too much stuff, but. Anyway, at least I made you all might see, okay? Probably, okay. And last but not least, final wish list is Hitachi. Just everything on Hitachi, gimme, gimme. Definitely wanna get some Blue Rose Beauty. Definitely wanna get the shampoo if it's there, and the chai hair tea. And I guess whatever else grabs my fancy. I still have a little Blue Rose in my stash as well. But I have no more shampoo. I'm out of the shampoo. And I may have just one chai hair tea, which isn't enough for me. So I want to be stuck on that. And then while I'm on Hitachi, I may browse around again, work with the shipping, and see if I could or should get anything else. So that's it. My first kind of Black Friday wishlist video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and let me know what you guys are thinking about getting or planning to get for Black Friday. I never really planned it out this much. Like, you guys are making me plan. Like, just doing this video, kind of prepping, like, okay, what I really want to get. Usually just I wake up on Black Friday, I see a sale and I go and check it out, and that's how I usually go. But no harm in being prepared, especially the fact that a lot of these things I want to get are always sold out. So maybe you guys are helping me to prepare, and maybe preparing I might have better success this year. So thank you. Thanks for watching. Definitely let me know what you guys are wishing for and what's on your Black Friday list down below. And let's chat products. See you in the next one. See you in my haul. Bye.